Welcome back. If you're just tuning in, this is 726 Harrison, right here in Harrison, Arkansas. And I am Ann Limley. This is my co-host for today, Lisa Dotson.
Hey, Ann.
How you doing, Lisa?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. And it's so good to have you. And I'm so glad you said, hey, I want to co-host with you on your
show.
Well,
I was just halfway teasing, but hey, it's been
fun. No, you weren't. You meant it.
Okay.
And here you are. You did. And it's good. I'm glad you're here. We have with us Jesse Carocchio. I kept saying his name because I wanted to pronounce it, and now I've got it. I will never forget it, ever, I hope. He's here with KCMH Christian Radio Station. And tell us a little bit about the radio station, where it's located on the
dial. 91.5 is where we're located right now on the dial. And about half of Harrison doesn't quite get 91.5. And so that's been an issue for some time now. Mm-hmm. And in 2003, we applied for a translator, a tower in Harrison.
Which would resolve that problem.
Yes. It would serve Harrison. It would not be for the benefit of reaching out any further. It's for the purpose of clearing up the signal in Harrison.
Right. Okay.
The little valley areas, our signal just doesn't get down very well. In fact, a lot of signals don't get down very well. And so this is really an excellent opportunity, and it only took the FCC until 2013 to give us an answer.
Wow.
So, they're prompt. I shouldn't say that.
Well, they've been very busy.
They have a lot going on.
Yes, they do. They did get overwhelmed, and they didn't process much of anything for that time period, and now they are processing everything, and we're very thankful. And we're very thankful to be granted the construction permit to be able to do that. Well, There's limited airspace.
That's awesome.
I've missed KCMH because I used to listen all the time, and then suddenly another station was bleeding over. And so I've been missing you for about 10 years or 13 or whatever you said. So
a lot of people have. And so we're excited to be able to offer this. You know, we actually spent probably about $10,000 on getting the license.
Okay.
And so now all we need is the equipment. We have tower space that we can rent. We've got the license. All we need is equipment.
And with that, you need funds for the equipment, correct?
Funds for the equipment, exactly. So we need $10,000 for the equipment alone. Now, KCMH is listener supported. So we only survive. We've been on the air 25 years. We survive by listener support, by business sponsors. And we have a few Harrison business sponsors here, which is wonderful. And we're going to need a few more with the new translator, but the $10,000 is just for the equipment alone.
Okay.
That will buy the transmitter, the receiver, the antennas, the tower, the line, the tower climbers, everything it's going to take to put it on the air.
The issue.
Which isn't that big of an expense in the grand scheme
of things. It's not. And we have just over $2,000 already donated just from people who have heard about it already.
Great.
Okay.
So now this weekend, we've put together an event here in Harrison that is free. Donations accepted.
Please
please donate. You don't have to come to the event to donate, but please come. It's going to be fun. We've put together a couple Southern Gospel groups. We've got Diamond State Trio is going to be there, as well as Southern Faith. Ron Hutchcraft from Ron Hutchcraft Ministries here in Harrison is going to be there, as well as possibly have some solos there as well. We're going to have food.
That's always
we'll get
a big
to eat.
Draw.
Hot dogs
Food.
Will be served. So that is exciting.
Hot dogs and
horse rides. His Pursuit Outdoors, a local organization, is going to be bringing horses by.
Awesome.
And they are doing that to help raise funds for Christian radio. So they are not charging us to be there.
Oh,
they believe in the ministry of KCMH and the Christian radio ministry.
And there you have a flyer up there on
that. That's right. And that lists all our sponsors as well. And, you know, I know there's been a lot of support that's not listed on there, but those are some of the main sponsors for this event specifically.
Okay. That's
so
great.
Very exciting. Now, it's going to be Saturday.
June
I understand 21st. That it could rain a little bit. Come out anyway. In between, they say scattered.
Yeah.
So in between, come out, ride a horse, listen to some music, get you a hot dog, enjoy the time.
And it's at the Minnie Harris stage.
Yes.
At the park.
The Minnie Harris Park stage.
Kicking off at 11.
Kicking off at 11.
Okay.
Horse rides, food, music will start at 12, 12 to 2.
And support a wonderful cause.
Yes.
That's right. That's what it's all about. So if you believe in Christian radio, if you want to have Christian radio here in Harrison where you can hear it anywhere, then support this event.
Okay.
So I'm excited to have Harrison be a part of getting Harrison Christian Radio on the air.
We appreciate
it. You know, I think that it's neat that it's worked out this way, that we had to raise funds for the equipment, because that means that, you know, Harrison can take ownership of it.
Love
so
it.
Very excited about it. And, you know, I'm excited about the difference that Christian Radio has made in so many lives when people are going through hard times and they need that word of truth, that, you know, that gospel message.
Yes.
It's there. And there's some powerful preachers. There's music, Southern Gospel in the morning, 9 to 11. Contemporary in the afternoon, 3 to 5.
Okay.
On the weekends, on Saturday, we've got a lineup of kids programs, audio dramas, and as well as a locally produced kids jam, which has some kids music and just fun stuff.
Well, thank you, Jesse. And please come out and support KCMH's benefit and help them raise funds for their transmitter. Or for the...
Yes.
Isn't that the correct term?
That's right. Okay. It will be on 99.1.
Okay.
And our goal at this point, we were shooting for September. It's looking like it's going to be the end of the year. We plan to have that on the air, but the money's got to be there to make it happen.
What benefits you is going to benefit all of us.
That's right. It's for the benefit of the community. We are a nonprofit organization, so it's tax deductible, and we are here to serve.
Okay. Thank you.
So, yeah.
Thank you. We appreciate you being
Absolutely.
Here and updating us.
You're
all
welcome.
Right.
Glad to be here.
We will be up next with the ladies from the Flora Delicious event that's coming up in Eureka. So stay with us, and we'll see you after break.